object oriented principles. These are the some of the principles from the object oriented paradigm. Classes, object, encapsulation, abstraction, inheritance, and polymorphism. Classes we have already seen. We see them in practical again now, and we'll see how to create physical objects, physical entities, and encapsulation. We see abstraction, hiding the unnecessary behaviors and exposing necessary functionality. Inheritance for extending the class, and polymorphism, it is similar to overriding and overloading. Class is a logical structure or design to create physical objects. To create any kind of physical object, you need to have the logical design, actually logical design, logical structure. Like it is a blueprint. When you go to any architect, if you want to construct any house, he will simply draw some structure of the house, structure of the building, and give you. By using the same structure, you can create any number of objects. Once the class is ready, you can create any number of objects out of it. Classes, another definition is classes template or blueprint to create objects. Another definition is class is collection of properties, that is variables, and behaviors, that is methods. Once class is created, you can create any number of objects. Example, building, person, car, whatever you take. Once the blueprint is ready, you can make any number of physical objects out of it. One thing to remember is when you simply create a class, does not occupy any memory. Then simply drawing on a paper does not require any space. You can draw any number of buildings, you can draw any number of cars on paper, but actually it does not require any kind of space. Space in the sense memory. When you simply create a class, it does not occupy any memory. When you actually create the object, then only the memory is required. At that time, the memory is allocated. This is how we create a class. Class is a keyword, and a class name, class curly braces, and class contains properties and behaviors such as methods. Object. Object is an instance of a class. Object is a physical implementation of class. Class is logical, whereas object is physical. Now, here you have a blueprint. Blueprint is class. When you create a car, this is physical thing. You can see it. It is physical implementation of class. Class does not contain any memory, whereas the object contains memory. Object needs memory. Object needs space. How to create object? Where or let? Simply similar to variables only, and variable name or object name, colon, class name, and class name braces. Class name is optional here. We know why. If you want, you can place the class name. Otherwise, you simply ignore it, because Swift has a feature of type inference. These two are same here. Variable Maruti car equal to car. Variable Audi, here I have not mentioned any data type. It is using type inference. Here it is using type annotation. Methods. Method is a block of statements which perform some specific task. Use func keyword to define methods. Func and method name, argument name, data type, and so on, and return type. Example, func start, it is returning nothing, and some set of statements which perform this functionality. Move with speed, you can also have the input arguments. This is what I am having here. Speed is input argument, and which move with speed is a method, and again it is not returning anything, it's simply performing. The car is moving with so and so speed. variety of methods. We have already seen them in functions. Functions with no arguments. There are no input. Functions with arguments. Argument 1 and argument 2. And returning nothing. Functions with objects. In functions, we have seen how to pass the primitive data types. Primitive data types means integer, float, string, double, character, bool. Here, char is custom data type. Char is object here. You can also pass the objects. Not only integers and floats, you can also pass the objects as input arguments. And you can also return objects as output. Return type is optional if it is void. Here I have not mentioned anything, any return type, because it is returning void. If you want, you can mention. Here I have mentioned here. This is optional. So I have not mentioned here. Type method and instance method. In Objective-C, we are having class methods and instance methods. Here, concept is same. Type method means, data type. Data type, on top of data type, if you call any method, that is called type method. To call that, we need some keywords, class or static. See, type methods. Class methods start with class or static keyword. Class methods cannot access the properties in the method implementations. Use class name to call the class methods. We will see them in practical, these statements. Properties can be accessed in the instance method. Instance method must be called on top of an object of the class. Okay. Method calling, object.methodName. Object.methodName, if you want to pass any value, you have to use the label and value, label and value. Here we are having some example here. Class car, variable, a property equal to 10. One instance method is a instance method. Whatever we have written so far, everything is instance methods only. If you want any class method, you have to use the, you have to specify either class or static. Class or static. This is similar function only. Additionally, we have class here. How to see how to call this method and how to call this method. I'm creating a car object here and I accessing property, car.property, car.instance method, car.aClass method. If you see here, it is not small car. It is not object, it is class actually. On top of class name, I am calling that here, car name. Sorry, car class name dot a property, it is giving error because a property is only accessible by using object but not the class name. On top of class name, you cannot access the property. Even if you see here, I am trying to access the class property instance variable. Properties are called instance variables. Instance variables means, instances means objects. In objects, you can use them. Instance methods, you can use them, but not the class methods or type methods. I'm trying to access the instance variable in class method. It is not allowed. It is giving error. Yeah. Here, I'm having person here. The super class of Swift object PC is NS object. You can mention that or you can ignore that. Here I'm having three properties: age, name, number of legs. The three behaviors of a person is walk, sleep, talk. I created one person. The person name is Modi. Basically, the person is pointed by Modi, and Modi.name equal to Modi. Modi dot number of legs equal to Modi dot age equal to 70, Modi dot walk, Modi dot talk. I am using the same class. I'm creating new person whose name is Advani, number of legs is 2, age equal to 78. For the Modi it is 70, for him it is 78. He sleep and he talks. What I mean to say here is, once a class is existing, you can create any number of objects out of it. Whenever you are setting the properties by using the variable name, it reflects in the same variable, same person. It reflects in if you try to change something on Modi, only Modi will be reflected, but not the Advani. Because Advani is pointed by Advani object, Advani pointer, whereas Modi is pointed by Modi pointer. Pointer in the sense, a variable where which stores the address in our case, but we are not having stars anywhere in Swift. We don't use the stars, but actually that is pointer only. Override, what we are doing here, same functionality we are having, and I'm overriding the init method. Actually, you don't need to override if you do not specify NS object here. If you specify it, you need to override it. Okay, we see what exactly the override keyword and how exactly it is used. Naming conventions we have already seen. Again, here class names should be upper camel case. This is how it should be. Upper camel case. Upper camel case in the sense, see, car, there is only one word, use the capital C. Building, only one word, use the capital B, uppercase B. Here, big car, there are two words. Whenever you are having two words, you have to use the upper camel case. B is caps, and the next words, the starting letter is caps. Bullet train, B and T are uppercase letters. Variable are objects. These are lower camel case. Maruti Suzuki. Second word, starting letter should be capital, or else now if it is a single word, you can use all are lowercase. If it is double word, you can use the lowercase, then next word, camel, capital case. Method names also same, lower camel case. Upper camel case means each letter of the starting letter of the word will be with the uppercase only. Whereas the lower camel case means first word should be in lower case, next word starting letter should be with capital camel case. Okay, let's see instance methods and class methods, right? I'm writing a class. Class book, and which is having number of pages, title of the book, price of the book. I have not given anything here. I'm just writing one init method. Pages is integer and underscore title. It is string underscore price. It is double or float. Just to differentiate, I am using most of the times you use general case and you use the self. Pages equal to underscore pages, title equal to underscore title, price equal to underscore price. This is a default insulator. This is a custom insulator actually. This is insulator, simply insulator. Let me write another function, static or class, describe this book is used refer animals. And I'm adding general functions. Those are instance methods. and display book. I'm trying to print title is title slash n pages slash n means new line and rise. Okay, here I want to mention this book is used to instead of this. I'll just try to access title of the book. Title means if I give ABC, ABC book is used for referring animals, similar to that. Here it is not underscore. Okay, now I'm trying to create a books. Let animal book equal to book. It is pages 200 pages, and the title is elephant, and price is 150. Animal book dot describe. It is not populating. Because the describe method is not instance method. This is instance, right? This is object. What is object? Object is an instance of a class, right? Object is an instance of a class. By using instance, I am trying to access the class method or type method, which is not allowed. Which is not allowed. Because how to use the class method? You have to use book dot describe. Book dot describe. You can describe about the book by using class, and then you can create object of it, and you don't need it here. Here animal book dot display book. You can use it wherever you want, but it always gives you the same result. One thing to remember is instance variables or properties are not allowed to access in class methods or type methods. This is cleared, so I'm removing it. And class methods cannot be accessed by using instance. This is not allowed. It gives the error. See what is the error also. Static member describe cannot be used on instance of book. This is static member. Static means class. You can also use the static. We are having separate keyword static. Both are same. Static or class, you can use anything here. Okay. How to create a type method or class method? You need to use the static keyword or class keyword to create class methods. Instance methods are default methods. Differences are clear. What is the instance method and what is the class method? Let me create a structure here. In case of structure, structures are also similar to classes, right? But only difference is we have seen couple of differences in previous class. Here, see, if you want to use class here, which is not allowed, maybe, let's see, what is that? Yes, class keyword can be used in only classes. In structure, if you want to create a type method, you have to use a static only. Class is not allowed in structure. Okay, this thing you need to remember. That is the difference between class properties. Like you can also have a class properties. Let's say I am going to create static where publisher string. Okay, I'm directly assigning some value here. I'll just modify that here. Now we can use this static property. Static means wherever you see static, that is related to class only or type. Here, now I can use publisher book. Publisher book is access, referred to by animals. What is this? String operator can be, sorry, we removed static here. Okay, in static methods you can access the static variables. In the next concept is about the properties and what are the different properties we can have. We'll see static properties, lazy stored properties. There are many. We'll see them. You need to remember is static properties. This is how you declare the class level properties. This is class method. In class method, you can access the class level properties. Now you might get one doubt. When do we use the static properties and when do we use the static methods actually? Okay. Static means the memory will be allocated only once for those variables. Let's say here. That a book I'm giving 120, title ABC 120 is the book. Let B book equal to book pages 210 EQR 191. Here, this book is entirely different. This book is entirely different. These values are different. These values are different. Even the values are same, this address is different and this address is different. Because when you create a book, three variables will be created in the memory. Those three variables are pages, title, and price. When you create B book, again, pages variable will be created, title variable will be created, price variable will be created. If you create another book, C book price is different. Price is different in the sense the memory location is different. And B book memory location is different. A book memory location is different. In case of static members are class level members. Okay. Only one publisher will be available. Only one memory location is available. That is on top of book, I'm having publisher. Publisher equal to let's say mega publications. If you print publisher here, it is same. Book dot publisher. Even if you print here, same. Even if you print out 100 line, same. If you change one place, in future the book publisher got changed. Then if you change here, everything will be reflected. All the places that will be reflected. Jyoti publisher. Now this book, when you create whatever variables you create from here onwards, will contain the Jyoti publishers. Even if you print wherever you print, the same thing will be displayed when you print it. Basically, Let me show you a practical slide here. Yeah, anyways, that is not that much important, but we need that in singleton. Whenever we are dealing with singleton, I will explain you what exactly the static property or a static function. Basically, we use static properties in case of singleton. Singleton, this is global actually, we can say it is global. When you create three books, 3 × 3 properties, 9 properties will be created, but publisher will be only one variable. Publisher will be only one variable. It won't create for each object, one publisher will not be created. For entire company, for entire books, only one publisher. Then properties are more important. These are the variety of properties we have in Swift. We see them in detail in next class.